Good morning, good afternoon, good night. Welcome back to my channel. For those of you who don't know who I am Nikita Rayana, and this channel covers all things beauty, all things motherhood, and just a little bit of everything under the sun. So in today's video, we're going to be covering my 2024 everyday makeup routine and pretty much focusing on my underpainting technique, which I always get questions about, and how I get my makeup to last throughout this high Atlanta weather this summer. So stick around if you want to see how I turn from this to this. I like to start off doing my eyebrows first before I do any type of moisturizing and priming on a nice, clean, freshly washed face. So let's jump right into it. I'm going to let y'all get a little bit closer. So for brows, I like to use either the NYX Micro Brow Pencil or the Ruby Kisses Super Slim Brow Pencil, which is a perfect dupe for the next one. So again, we're going in with a very, very blank canvas just so that product can grip directly to the brow hairs and to your skin. And I have an updated brow routine video on my TikTok page. So if you guys really wanna see a little bit more in depth of how I do my eyebrows, then just head over to my TikTok, which will be linked in the description below. And y'all can see exactly how I do it because I won't be talking this time. So now that the brows are done, y'all can see how I did them. I only put a little bit of concealer underneath the bottom of my eyebrow. Now this step is important to only put the concealer underneath your brow because I like to go in with my foundation color and fill in the top of my brow. So what I like to do first is go in with my moisturizer. I like to use the Good Molecules Daily Moisturizer. This is literally like the best moisturizer for my skin. I have oily skin, but lately it's been a little bit dry. The key to longevity and a flawless base is to make sure that it is moisturized. And after that, I like to go in with my relevant sunscreen primer. And I like to use only a little bit of this because a little definitely goes a long way. But this is going to also help because it's a primer. So it's a foreigner. It's a sunscreen, a primer, and a moisturizer and something else, y'all. And let those products settle into the skin. Afterwards, I like to go in with my e.l.f. Power Grip Primer, y'all. I have another one that's newer, but I don't know where I put it at. I've misplaced it. So this is my old one. And again, you really don't need that much product, but you can apply it based on your preference. But I like to put this much on, as you can see. You see how the skin is definitely looking glowy, and then we're just gonna let it dry down a little bit. So it should look like this. So once you've got your base nice and ready, nice and grippy and ready for your makeup application, now we're gonna go in and do my underpainting technique. So with my underpainting technique, I like to start with my bronzer, my contour, those shades first. So I like to use the Ruby Kisses Cream Foundation, guys, and this is a recent find of mine. I like to use an angle brush, a dense one, to go in and apply this all over my face. So again, I just put on a little bit on my brush and then I go to town in all of my areas that I'm basically contouring, you know? So this includes my cheekbones, my forehead, my jawline, and my nose. But I like to bring it into my eye. That's the trick here too. You see how I'm bringing it into the outer corners of my eye? That's how we get a seamless blend, because when you're doing makeup, you want everything to look seamless. You don't wanna know where concealer starts and your blush ends, or where concealer ends and your blush starts. You want everything to blend seamlessly together. That's the goal. So this is this application, and it may look a little harsh, y'all, but just bear with me. So So now we are going to go in with the blush placement. And this is another tip that I really want y'all to kind of remember and kind of stick to. It doesn't really matter how much you spend on your products, but what does matter is that you know how to use them. And that if you are gonna focus on a brand, try to stick with the same brand throughout your makeup process. So essentially this just means to, if you're gonna pick up a foundation or a concealer set, try to stick with that same brand because they have curated their products so that they work seamlessly together to give you the best application and the best color payouts and the best longevity. With that being said, we're gonna go in with the e.l.f. Camo Liquid Blush. Okay, and this one is in Gorge Orange, but the way that I do my concealer, because this specific blush formula is very, very intense, I like to do very light drops on my face like this. Very light. I'm going to be using the Real Techniques Multitasking Cheek Brush to blend this out. And we're just going to go ahead and go to town and start buffing her in. And again, I'm going to make sure I blend that into my eye. Now that we have done our sculpting, basically we're going to go in and start highlighting and concealing. So like I said, I will be using e.l.f. and this is the 16 hour camo concealer. And y'all, at first I did not like this concealer until I bought their setting spray, and it definitely changed the way this concealer applied for me, for real. So like I said, we're going to go in with the e.l.f. concealer. How we're going to place her, so I'm going to put a little bit here, and then repeat the same on the opposite side. Like this. And I like to put only a little bit on my cheeks, guys. So you're gonna go in with your setting spray, your whatever spray you use. I like to use the same brand, so I'm going to be using the e.l.f. Power Grip Dewy Setting Spray. I spray my brush, and I spray my face. This also is the trick to getting your makeup to last. If you spray your makeup in between the layers, that is the trick to getting your makeup to last, so keep that in mind. Then I'm gonna go in and blend this out before my camera overheats. And when I'm blending out, I like to start at the edges of my concealer, okay? As opposed to going directly up. You wanna start with the perimeter of your concealers. And you see that I'm tapping that concealer in, I'm not dragging it. Keep that in mind, to tap and buff it in. Don't drag your brush when you're blending your makeup. That goes for your eyeshadow as well. You want to buff it, tap it, press it, don't drag. So I'm gonna blend this out and I'm gonna come right back. Throughout this whole process, you're gonna see me blending out my makeup with brushes mostly. That's because I've been through a lot of trial and error with beauty blenders, sponges and everything. So over the years, taking a liking to brushes. They seem to blend out a lot better and they, you know, make the process a lot easier for me. Now with that being said, I am going to go in with a triangle powder puff and we're just gonna press underneath that under eye. There is nothing on this powder puff at all, but we're gonna use it to just nicely, you know, get that concealer nice and buff. So in the beginning, I told you guys, when you're doing your makeup, you wanna make sure that it's seamless and that you cannot see where something is starting and ending at, basically. So right now you can see that where the concealer is ending and the contour is beginning. So this is how we fix that. So one, you're gonna take a actual buffer, a brush, whatever you wanna use. I'm using the end of this puppy. And I'm gonna start here with this outer corner and we're gonna just buff it together, just like that. Now once we're done with that, we're gonna go back in with those same brushes or tools that we use to put on our contour. And we're gonna go back in and reapply our contour. Now is when you can be a little bit more messy. As you can see, I'm going directly over that concealer line so that I am buffing it together so it's not a harsh straight line. And I'm gonna also take that over everywhere that I highlighted, over the, you know, the edges of the highlighted areas basically, so that I can get it to blend and be really seamless. And that includes my nose area. fucking with our blush brush or, you know, any more blush. Like I said, you can put on more product. I promise you, you can put more product on top because this is about making sure that it all shines through. So you see how I'm going back in with those same tools to blend it in together so that it's not a harsh line and that it's nice and seamless. So we're just gonna keep doing this until everything molds and melts together. Just like so. Now that we're done with our concealer, our highlighting, our contouring, now we can move into our actual base to get everything snatched together. So this is where we put in our foundation. You can use like a CC10, a BB cream, whatever you want to use. But I like to use my foundation and I like to use the Fit Me Matte and Poreless. And this one is in number 330, shade Toffee Caramel. I first like to go in with that same little flat angle brush and do the top of my eyebrows. This is where we clean them up, y'all. Boom, done with that. So now I'm going to take that same foundation and that same brush and I'm going to dip it in the foundation and I'm gonna take off some of it because we don't need too much, but I'm going to place it on my face like so. Just like so. And essentially, I'm placing it in the areas that I did not put any products, basically, so that I can get those other areas blended in together. Just like this. Afterwards, you want to go back in with your setting spray, guys. I told y'all, this is your best friend. So I'm going to spray, 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 spray. Literally, spray, all right? And then we're gonna fan it just a little bit, and then we're gonna go in and start blending and buffing her out, okay? So, now that we're done with that, you can see that I put on a little bit more concealer, just a small dot of it. So, like I said, because we want everything to be seamless, I'm just going to use this placement now to bring back that highlight so that we don't lose that highlight. So I'm just lightly buffing her out so that we can bring back that highlight and make sure that we define those areas that we snatched, essentially, you know? So I'm just lightly buffing it back out with my concealer brush, and then I'm going to take my puff again to help blend that together. Perfect. Hey. All right, so now we can start setting up our face. So I'm going to be starting with the Fit Me Matte and Poreless pressed powder. This one is in 332 Golden Caramel, and I put a little bit of that on my puff, and I'm going to take that and set my under eye with it first. This is the color I'm not really fucking with it. This is the Halo Glow setting powder, and I'm gonna use a nice small little brush, and I'm gonna put up a little bit of that. Just a little bit, and we're gonna go in and we're going to press her. I'm gonna go in with a flat brush, and then we're gonna use that to set the rest of our face. Be careful of the areas that we have our highlighted powder on, okay? Just like that. So that I am sticking beside her. I love the Physicians Formula Butter Bronzer. And I'm using that to set my contour shape. So I'm only gonna put down a little bit because a little of this bronzer goes a very, very long way around the perimeters of my face. So now that I let it sit for a little bit, now we're gonna take a big fluffy brush and we're just gonna buff everything out. The Our Heart Revolution Peach and Glow blush palette. Y'all, I love this blush palette. I'm going with that and we're going to reignite that blush. Not much of it. And then we're gonna go in and we're going to do our setting spray. So again, I am still a sucker for highlights, so yes, I love to use my highlight, y'all. Okay, now we can move on to finishing the eye so that we can really complete the look. I went ahead and did a little bit of bronzer on my waterline and I put my lashes on. So now we can get into the lip. Now this is my current favorite lip combo that I've been loving. So I'm gonna come and bring y'all closer and I'm gonna show y'all. But before we start, I am using the Amour US and the Kiehl's Persistent pencils. I don't know the shades. I know the Amour US one is in brown, but let's bring y'all closer. Brown shade. This one is in Shy, and we're just gonna put a little bit of this. And that is the finished look, guys. So hopefully you enjoyed and you picked up a few tips and picked up a few of my little tips and my tricks and that you will apply them and see a difference in your everyday routine. I absolutely love it compared to doing face first or anything. I absolutely love it. If you enjoyed, don't forget to like, comment, and subscribe. Share this video with your friends. This is very beginner friendly and the products are beginner friendly and it's just perfect all around in my opinion. So again, like I said, thank you so much for tuning in. And bye.